This was William Powell's first movie at MGM after the death of his fiancée Jean Harlow. And he decided to do it, he said, because of something which had happened to him in Europe. Powell was traveling to help recover from his grief, and one day while in Rome, he overheard a very excited young boy on the street speaking to a friend in Italian. Well, Powell asked a friend of his what the boy was saying, what excited the boy so much. And it seems that the young man was excited because he'd just been given money from his parents to go to a movie. And he was telling his pal that he was going to go see a William Powell movie because he said, William Powell makes me laugh. Hearing that by coincidence went a long way towards helping Bill Powell out of his depression. It made him think about going back to work, which he soon did in a comedy. Up next, more adventures with Nick and Nora Charles.
Tonight on Turner Classic Movies, star of the month, Myrna Loy, continues to shine bright as Nora Charles in Shadow of the Thin Man. Then William Powell's Nick Charles takes Myrna home to his parents in The Thin Man Goes Home. And Myrna and Bill investigate a jazz club murder in Song of the Thin Man. Turner Classic Movies stays open all night.
You're watching Turner Classic Movies.
We have more adventures with Nick and Nora Charles coming up, the delightful duo played again by William Powell and our star of the month, Myrna Loy. Our next film is Shadow of the Thin Man from MGM in 1941, the fourth film in the popular series that teamed Powell and Myrna Loy with director Woody Van Dyke. And Myrna Loy, you know, became a true staple in the career of William Powell. In many ways, it was a case of whenever MGM wanted to make some surefire money, they would simply re-team the two of them. And not just in the Thin Man movies. The truth is, they made only six films as Nick and Nora Charles, but all told, they did 14 films together, all between the years of 1934 and 1947. Personally, they were also very good friends. Powell called Loy Minnie, actually, and she called him Mr. Pooh. And I think you'd have to be a friend to let anybody call you Mr. Pooh. As for this next Thin Man mystery, it takes Nick and Nora to the racetrack, where, not unexpectedly, there's a murder most foul. Among the suspects, you'll be seeing a beautiful young Donna Reed in one of her first movie roles. You'll also see Stella Adler, who went on to become the celebrated drama coach. She's the one that Marlon Brando always credited as the teacher who had the greatest influence on his career. This movie was released in early December of 1941, just before Pearl Harbor. And it was exactly the kind of escapism that audiences were looking for to take their mind off how grim things were in the real world. Here is Shadow of the Thin Man. The man who directed this film, Woody Van Dyke, was famous for being a really fast but efficient director. And to give you some indication of how fast he worked, Shadow of the Thin Man was filmed in just 2 weeks, an amazingly swift time for a movie considered one of MGM's important A pictures. So no wonder MGM loved One Take Woody. He didn't waste anybody's time. It was shortly after this film that MGM started building Donna Reed as a star, but it would be 5 years before she made the movie she's most famous for today, It's a Wonderful Life. And after making Shadow of the Thin Man in 1941, Myrna Loy basically retired from the screen for 3 years, keeping busy with World War II work and looking after a new husband. It would be 3 years before the next Thin Man movie was made, number 5. And we have it coming up next.
Tonight on Turner Classic Movies, our star of the month, Myrna Loy, gets the bad guys, and the thin man goes home. Then married sleuths Myrna and William Powell mix murder and jazz in Song of the Thin Man. And heiress Myrna marries a penniless man in Lucky Night. Turner Classic Movies is up with you all night.
Bryce Kelly,
Spencer Tracy,
Vincent Minnelli.
Typical Hollywood story.
Damn good actors.
Jacques Tourneur, the director, said to me when I first met him, "Now, in this picture," he didn't speak English very well, "do you know the word impassive?" "Yes, impassive, impassive, that's right. That's what I want, impassive, right, yes. No big eyes."
"You dirty little phony. Go on, lie some more. Tell me how you handled things for me in San Francisco. Tell me it was all Joe's idea. Go on, Kathy. Show me how you're gonna squirm your way out this time."
That was his direction to me. He said, "First half, good girl. Last half, bad girl." Simple. That's what he wanted. That's what I gave him.
"You're no good for anyone but me. You're no good, and neither am I. That's why we deserve each other."
Jacques Tourneur shows us that the language of cinema is universal with Out of the Past. Saturday at 8 a.m. Eastern here on Turner Classic Movies.
When we started out, only a few knew about it. A cool, dark place hidden away from the crowd. It wasn't private. Anybody could come. But the ones who got it never left. And because of them, we've kept things just the way they are. Uncut, and not an interruption in sight. So, when you come by, this is all you need to say. TCM.